The Underground Railroad is a historical fiction novel by American author Colson Whitehead, published in 2016. The novel tells the story of Cora and Caesar, two slaves in the South during the 19th century, who make a bid for freedom from their Georgia plantation by following the Underground Railroad, which the novel depicts as a rail transport system with safe houses and secret routes. The book won several literary awards, including the Pulitzer Prize for Fiction, the National Book Award for Fiction, the Arthur C. Clarke Award, and the 2017 Andrew Carnegie Medal for Excellence. Cora is a teenager, who runs away from a Georgia plantation where her family have been slaves for three generations. Cora's grandmother, Ajari, was brought there from Africa on a slave ship and died after many years of hard work on the Randall plantation. Cora's mother, Mabel, ran away, leaving Cora behind, and Cora has since been obsessed by finding out more about her. The other slaves took advantage of her after this escape, although she can be quite headstrong and bold, especially when she protected a young slave against their cruel master Terence. When she runs away, in the company of another slave called Caesar, they narrowly escape some locals that try to catch them. Cora kills a teenage white boy in order to do so, and they finally get to the Underground Railroad, which is an actual railroad below ground with stops under farms and houses. The train takes them to South Carolina, where they can live freely. They meet Sam, a kind white station agent, and he provides them with new identities. They can stay in a house, are fed well, and have work, so it's a vast improvement over the living conditions they were used to before. Cora first works as a maid, and then works in a museum, portraying the African slave life to be much better than it actually is. Sam also shares that the hospital that they thought was helping them with free medical care was conducting experiments to sterilize and kill black people. When Ridgway, a notorious slave catcher on the hunt for them, arrives in town, Cora manages to get to the Underground Railroad, but Caesar is left behind and Sam's house goes up in flames. She ends up in North Carolina, where the situation for her is much worse. She's taken into the home of a hesitant station agent called Martin, and his wife Edith, who's distraught at her presence. She lives in the attic, and notices a spectacle each Friday evening, when there's a festival on the town square where racist propaganda is spread and a black person is hanged. Cora gets better at reading, but has nowhere to go, and when she gets sick, she's taken into the house to be cared for. The maid Fiona informs on the family, and one Friday night a group of riders visit the house, together with Ridgway, who captures Cora, while Edith and Martin are hanged. Things get worse when they travel to Tennessee, as Cora is taken through the state by Ridgway and his two companions, Bozeman, who wears a necklace of human ears, and a strange black boy called Homer. They also picked up a runaway called Jasper who's singing all the time. They travel through areas scattered with wildfires, and all of a sudden Ridgway shoots Jasper, annoyed by his singing. They stop at a town, and a young black man with glasses notices her. Ridgway takes her to dinner and tells her about the death of Caesar, before they go to the woods just outside the town to sleep. Bozeman tries to abuse Cora, but Ridgway stops him by punching him. Then, the black man arrives armed, with two allies, and they shoot Bozeman, and Ridgway and Homer are captured and chained. Cora meets the man that saved her, Royal, a conductor of the Underground Railroad, who takes her to the Valentine Farm in Indiana. There she's truly free as they attend school and work on the farm, together with a vibrant black community. She and Royal develop a romance, and she grows closer to her housemate Sybil and her daughter, Molly. The farm belonged to a light-skinned black man called John Valentine, who often was passed as white. Every Saturday night there's a party with lectures, poetry, singing and dancing, but the nearby white community is getting restless and nervous about this growing black community. When Royal takes her on a picnic, he shows her an abandoned house with a station to the railroad underground. The train doesn't fit because of the narrow tunnel, so there's only a handcar. She gets uneasy about this whole thing, since she doesn't want to go anywhere, but wants to settle down on the farm forever. Sam passes the farm one day, on his way to California, and he tells Cora that Terrence Randall is dead, so she's no longer hunted down. One night, two speakers, Mingo and Lander, are debating the future of the farm, when a white mob barges in, killing Lander, Royal, and many others. They burn down the farm, and Cora is captured once again by Ridgway and Homer, who command her to take them to the station under the abandoned house. Cora leads them there, and she pulls Ridgway down the stairs, fatally wounding him. Homer looks after Ridgway, as Cora takes off on the handcar, with which she travels for miles, until she's met with sunlight. She meets a black man called Ollie, who drives a wagon, and is looking to join a wagon train in St. Louis, heading to California. She wonders about his story, which he will surely share along the way. We also learn that Cora's mother never made it further than the swamp next to the Randall plantation. As she felt she couldn't leave her daughter, she decided to return, only to be bitten by a poisonous snake, her body disappearing forever in the swamp. If you'd like to make a suggestion about what book I should summarize, please let me know in the comments, and if you enjoyed this, please like and subscribe.